welcome to the post-market update from Nirmal Bang. I am Hiral Dadia. What a day of trade, because clearly Indian equity markets have posted losses for a second consecutive session, and this was mainly on the back of weak global cues as well as the rising number of cases in terms of coronavirus in the country. In fact, the oil glut is something which has had an impact in today's session as well. Clearly, we did end off the day's lowest levels. However, there was a mild attempt that the markets made to recover in the last hour of trade. And it was mainly the global cues that actually triggered this kind of a sell-off. So a clear carnage that we've seen on the Lal Street in today's session. In fact, if you see crude, that has capitulated, and that's something which has been rattling the stock markets across the globe as well. For Nifty and Sensex, it's a biggest single day fall that we've seen in history. Nifty in intraday session did slip below that 10,300 mark, but on the back of the mild recovery that we did see in the last hour of trade, it settled almost near levels of 10,450. Sensex and Nifty ended with cuts of almost 5.2% and 4.9% respectively. And it was the biggest intraday fall in absolute terms for Sensex. And it closed at the lowest level since February 2019 as well. For Bank Nifty, it's seen cuts of almost 20% from its record high levels. So clearly Bank Nifty has entered that bear territory, and all components of Bank Nifty were trading in the red. Sectoral indices as well, all of them were in the red. In fact, it was the metal index that was the top losing sector in today's day of trade. And there was selling pressure on the broader markets as well. However, they managed to outperform the benchmark indices. It was mainly oil prices that were on, you know, the forefront today. That is something which actually impacted the money markets, because if you see, overall, you had clearly the oil price war, which was impacting the 10-year yields, which dropped to below that 6% mark. This is the lowest level that we've seen since August 2003. In terms of the VIX, that was almost at a 10-month high. And you had stocks like Reliance Industries, HDFC Bank, ICICI Bank and HDFC. These were the top contributors to Nifty as well as the Sensex fall. And the advance decline ratio also forward the best. However, there were only around 3 to 4 stocks on Nifty 50 that managed to stay in the positive. So that's our sum up of how the markets have actually done in today's session. But let's quickly have a look on the individual counters. The four names that we need to mention is, Yes Bank, BBCL, Bharti Infratel and IOC on the gaining front. However, ONGC, Vedanta, Z Entertainment, Reliance Industries and IndusInd Bank, these were the top losers in trade today. On BSE 500, let's understand which were the top losers that we need to watch out for, because clearly, though in terms of the broader markets, there was some bit of outperformance that did come in, but there were major cuts that we were witnessing as well in terms of individual counters. Overall, if you see on BSE 500, you had stocks like Wellspun Corp, Bliss GVS Pharma, Centrum Capital, Edelweiss Financial, Indiabulls Housing, PNB Housing Finance. These were few of the top losers on BSE 500. Whereas you had stocks like Vodafone Idea, Shipping Corporation, JN Irrigation, Dishman Carbogen, Future Lifestyle. These were few of the top gainers as well on BSE 500. Let's understand the quantum of stocks that hit a 52-week low, because they were already in three digits on NSE stocks that hit a 52-week low. You had Axis Bank, Coal India, Hero Moto, L&T, Adani Ports, M&M to name a few on Nifty 50. In fact, 10 stocks in Nifty 50 hit a 52-week low in today's day of trade. On BSE 500, you had stocks like ACC, Aditya Birla Capital, Apollo Tyres, BEL, BEML. These were a few of the names that hit a 52-week low. Whereas a huge list of banking counters that are 52 that hit a 52-week low. So, to name a few of the banks, you can see them on the screen as well. But Allahabad Bank, Bandhan Bank, Central Bank of India, IDFC First Bank, JNK Bank, PNB, RBL, United Bank. These were a few of the banking counters that actually hit a 52-week low in today's day of trade. So clearly, if you go to see, the mayhem has continued from the global market sell-off. It has come in to the Indian markets as well. And the market breadth, that remained pretty much in favor of the declines. You almost had a little over 1,400 stocks that ended the day with losses, while only 175 stocks eked out gains. And this I'm talking about mainly on Nifty 50, on NSE. There was almost around 7 lakh crore quantum of market capitalization that was, you know, wiped off. And this is the kind of slump that we've seen in today's day of trade. It's going to be interesting to see what are the FII and DII numbers that look like as well once they come in. But clearly now, a lot of stock-specific action that we need to watch out for from here on. Indigo spice chart, these counters ended higher on the back of lower crude prices. ONGC ended at a 15-year low on higher crude prices. Paint companies were up in trade. And apart from that, if you go to see, even OMCs were trading, higher on, lower crude prices. But away from there, Reliance was trading at the lowest level that we saw since August 2019. In fact, the market cap has fallen 7 lakh crores, below 7 lakh crores. And in fact, it was TCS that actually has overtaken Reliance Industries as well in terms of market capitalization. Yes Bank and ended higher as well on the back of the resolution plan, whereas you had the fund infusion by SBI and Yes Bank that kept SBI under check. So two inverse moves that did come in on a Yes Bank as well as an SBI Bank. Max Financial again ended lower on the back of the exposure that they have to Yes Bank. Moving away from there, you have Indiabulls Housing Finance as well. That ended lower on the exposure that they have to 81 bonds. And Yes Bank owns the company almost 662 crores via the 81 bonds. Moving away from this entire scenario, Fortis ended lower, a large block deal that did take place on this counter. IndusInd Bank also ended in the red. In fact, they have deferred their plans with regards to fundraising goes. So overall, a lot of movers and shakers, a lot of shakers more than movers in today's day of trade. But it has been a complete mayhem that we've witnessed. No one was spared in terms of individual sectors, all sectors that were ended in the negative. And clearly today we did tell you in the morning as well that the expectation was that there would be weakness, that negative bias does continue. It is a truncated week. Tomorrow is Holi. So there was a lot of selling that could have been expected, profit booking that could have been taking place as well. But overall, as of now, global market action is going to be crucial. What happens in the US as well as tomorrow being a truncated week for India, what happens in the European markets as well as how Asia opens into tomorrow's session is going to be crucial, because overall the trend is looking weak. There is that selling pressure that is expected to continue. A lot of macro data that we will be watching out for, but clearly a 4.5 to 5% cut coming in on the Nifty and Sensex, and Bank Nifty already entering the bear territory. That's all that we have in the post-market update. In fact, to get more updates, you could follow us on our YouTube channel and, you know, follow us and like our pages on Instagram, Twitter and Facebook.